Welcome back, friends. So in our previous session we had seen what verbs are, right? We had a short introduction to verbs, and we also tried what tenses are, right? We talked about tenses. We have already seen what tenses are. We had looked at the form of various tenses. We saw that there are three basic tenses, and we also looked at the details of all the tenses, right? So we had an idea about the form of tenses. Now our next task is to examine in detail what the various uses of tenses are, when each tense is used. Okay, so let's check it out. So friends, let's check out the uses of each tense one by one. First, we have before us on the screen the simple present tense. Okay, all of you must be familiar with the uses of simple present tense, but let me just repeat it so that it becomes thorough with you. The first usage is to express habits, general truths, repeated actions or unchanging situations, emotions and wishes. Okay, so we have example for each of them. For example, let's take habit first. Okay, so speaking about habit, if I say I smoke, right, it's a habit. When you express a habit, you don't use the present continuous tense. I cannot say I am smoking. If newspaper reading is my habit, I would say I read the newspaper. But if drinking tea is my habit, I would say I drink tea, right? So look at the examples even. He drinks tea at breakfast, which means that is his regular habit. Okay, he does that every day. And when I say they watch a movie every Saturday, it's quite clear that it is something which happens every week. It's not an isolated incident, or it is not something which is happening at the time of speaking. It is nothing but a habit. Okay. Next, we have examples for unchanging situation. Okay, when I say I work in Chennai, okay, you know that for at least the past few months or maybe years, it has been so. When I say I work in Chennai, so this is my present situation. Okay, so when I say I work in Chennai, we assume that this situation doesn't change. When I say he stays with his mother, it's again an unchanging situation. So that doesn't mean that this status cannot be changed at all, but for the present situation, you know, we assume that it doesn't change. Next, general truth. Speaking about general truths, look at this example. Delhi is a large city. Okay, that is a common knowledge, right? It's common knowledge that Delhi is a large city, so it's considered a general truth. Okay, we never say that Delhi was a large city or Delhi will be a large city, because we know Delhi has been always so. It's a general truth. Similarly, water boils at 100 degrees. Okay, it's a scientific fact. It doesn't change. The moon revolves around the earth. Again, a general truth. Moon always revolves around the earth, right? So we don't have to change tense. We don't have to speak about it in past tense or about in future tense. It is something which never changes. So the moon revolves around the earth. Similarly, we use the simple present tense for speaking about repeated actions. We catch the bus every morning. Okay, something which happens every day. So we cannot say we are catching the bus every morning, or we will catch the bus every morning. No, we catch the bus every morning. Similarly, it rains every afternoon in the hot season, and they drive to Mumbai every summer. Fine. We also use the simple present tense to give instructions or directions. Okay, usually imagine that someone is asking you the way to some place. Okay, then what tense will you use to give him directions? Obviously, you will use the simple present tense. See, you walk for 200 meters, then you turn left. So it's in the simple present tense. Can you use any other tense to do this? Can I put it in past tense? No, I cannot. Because when someone is asking you for instructions, it is in present tense. Insert the key into the slot and start the machine. Okay. All of you must have seen user manuals, right? When you buy a new home appliance, say a television or a refrigerator or an air conditioner, you'll have a user's manual with it. So what tense will be the user's manual in? It will be in simple present tense. And not only home appliances, imagine if you're buying Maggi noodles, you have instructions to cook, right? What tense is it? Is it in past tense or is it in future tense? It is in simple present tense, right? Next. To express fixed arrangements, present or future. Okay. So whenever we talk about arrangements which have been made, we are planning to do something, then that is in simple present tense. Okay. The show starts at 9. Here we know that it is already planned. The show is supposed to begin at 9. It is an event which is fixed in the future. So we can use the simple present tense for this purpose. His mother arrives tomorrow. Okay. So here what you have to keep in mind is that the arrangement can be in present or in future. When I say the show starts at 9, maybe when I say this, the time may be about 8:50. Okay. So the proximity doesn't matter. The mother arrives tomorrow. So this happens the next day. Okay. Our holiday starts on the 4th May. Next. To express future time after some conjunctions like after, when, before, as soon as, until, etc. Look at the example. He'll give it to you when you come next Saturday. She'll call you before she leaves. So this is similar to what we saw sometime back, similar to the previous point. But here the verb comes after certain words like after, when, etc. Okay, that's all. Next, the present continuous tense. When someone uses the present continuous, they are thinking about something that is unfinished or incomplete. Look at the usages of present continuous. It can be used to describe an action that is going on at this moment. Okay, you are listening to me, right? And I am teaching you grammar. So that action is not complete. So whenever the action is not complete, this tense can be used. Okay, friends, one more thing you have to keep in mind. When I say this tense can be used for so and so purpose, don't think that this is the only tense that can be used. Okay, if it is the only tense that can be used for this purpose, I'll mention it specifically. But unless mentioned, when I say a tense can be used for this purpose, you have to understand that it can be used. Maybe other tenses can also be used. Okay, so it's not exclusive. Okay, because an action which is going on can be described using other tenses as well. You are listening to me, I'm teaching English grammar. So these are actions which are going on while I'm speaking, while I'm uttering this sentence, these events are happening, right? Next, to describe an action that is going on during this period of time or a trend. See, when I ask someone, are you still working at Infosys? So it's an action going on at this period of time, right? If he had worked at Infosys 10 years back, I would not ask him such a question. And look at the second example. More and more people are joining Facebook. So what does that sentence express? It expresses a trend, something which is becoming popular now, something which the public is following a lot. Okay. Next, to describe an action or event in the future which has already been planned or prepared. Okay. So this is one way of using the present continuous tense to express future tense. I think I already explained this. When I say we are going on a holiday tomorrow, It's a plan. A plan has already been made. Okay. So we know, though the tense used is present continuous, the time which we are speaking about is not in the present. When is it? It's in the future. I am meeting my boyfriend tonight. Again, the tense used is present continuous, but it's an arrangement in the future, right? Something which has already been planned. Are they visiting you next winter? We can also use this tense to describe a temporary event or situation. She usually wears sari, but she is wearing jeans for the party tonight. The weather forecast was good, but it's raining at the moment. Okay, so in both these things, what is happening now is only temporary. In the first sentence, she usually wears sari. Okay, but now what is going to happen is an exception to that, a temporary event. But for tonight's party, she is wearing jeans. Okay. This tense is also used with always, forever, constantly, etc. to describe and emphasize a continuing series of repeated actions. Look at the example. George is always coming late to the class. You're forever complaining about your neighbors. So here we see that the present continuous tense follows words like always and forever. Okay. We use them in such a way when certain events happen repeatedly, when it becomes almost routine. If George comes late for one day, I cannot say George is always coming late, right? If he repeats this action twice or thrice, then I can say George is always coming late to the class. Again, this is something which you should be very careful about. Some verbs are not used in the continuous form. Okay. So the verbs which are listed below are normally used in the simple present tense. Okay. Because they are rather states of mind, or rather than being actions or processes. Look at those examples given. I have divided them into various topics like senses. We have feel, hear, see, smell, taste, etc. Okay. When I say I feel sick, it is not an action. Okay. No action is being performed when I say I feel sick. It is only a state of my mind or my body when I say I feel sick. Similarly, when I say this curry tastes salty, there am I performing any action? No. It's just a state. Okay. A state of my tongue. It's a sense. Similarly, we have words like assume, believe, consider, doubt, feel, suppose, think, etc. Okay, all those we use in the context of opinions. Again, there are mental states like forget, imagine, know, mean, notice, recognize, remember, understand, etc. Okay, so all these words are not used in the present continuous tense. You cannot tell that I am understanding what you are saying. That's wrong. You should only say I understand what you say. Okay. So it's wrong to tell someone that I am understanding or I am remembering. Under emotions and desires, we have words like envy, fear, dislike, hate, hope, like, love, mind, prefer, regret, want, wish, etc. Okay. So you can't say I am loving his voice. No. You should only say I love his voice. Other words are contain, cost, hold, measure, weigh, look, seem, have, etc. So I told you that words like see, hear, feel, taste, smell, etc. cannot be used in the continuous form. Okay, usually they are not used in the continuous form, but there are exceptional cases when we use them in the continuous form. But in such situations, they have a different meaning. When I say this bag feels rough and heavy, what happens? There what form of the word am I using? I'm using the simple present tense form, right? This bag feels rough and heavy. When I say that, it's about my perception of the bag's qualities. But when I say feeling, it has some other meaning. Jiva is feeling much better now. It means his health is improving, right? Similarly, the minister has 3 cars and 4 houses. There is a simple present form. Now the present continuous of has is what? Having. When I say she's having lunch, it has another meaning. Having means eating. Okay? I can see Razak in the garden. So there it refers to my perception. Okay, my sense of sight. But when I say I am seeing Mary later, it means we are planning to meet. Mary and I will be meeting at some time. Okay? So that is the difference. Or when I say I smell something sweet, what does that mean? There it refers to my sense of smelling. Okay? But if I say I am smelling something sweet, what does it mean? Then it means I am taking something in my hand and smelling it. So you should get the difference. Okay?